first chapter of standard 8, that is living world and classification of microbes. So let's see the contents. First, biodiversity and need of classification. Second, five kingdom system of classification. Third, characteristics of kingdom Monera, Protista and fungi. Fourth, classification of microorganisms such as bacteria, protozoa, fungi, algae, viruses and their characteristics. Let's see our first topic, that is biodiversity and need of classification. So guys, what do you mean by biodiversity? Biodiversity refers to all variety of plants and animals which can be found on earth. So all the living organisms survive on the earth according to geographic region, food ingestion, defense, etc. All the living organisms on the earth which are surviving or living on the earth have adapted according to the geographic region. Geographic region means what? The mountains, deserts, grasslands, rainforest, etc. Then the food ingestion. Food ingestion means taking in the food. Afterwards, the defense. Defense means to fight against enemy. According to 2011 census, around 87 million species were found on the earth. In 2011 census, there were 87 million species were found on the earth, including land and sea. So to study such vast number of species, it was essential to divide them into groups. So the groups and subgroups were created. Now the process of this dividing the living organisms into groups or subgroups is called as biological classification. Now let's see five kingdom system of classification. Robert Harding Whittaker in year 1920 to 1980 was an American ecologist. Robert Harding Whittaker kaun the? American ecologist. What do you mean by ecologist? Ecologist is a scientist who study about how plants and animals interact with the environment. So in year 1969 he divided living organisms into five groups. And for this classification, he considered following criteria. Let's see the criteria. First, complexity of cell structure. Cell structure ki complexity, that is prokaryotic and eukaryotic. Prokaryotic means single cell organisms without nucleus. And eukaryotic means unicellular or multicellular organisms with well-defined nucleus. Second, or complexity of organisms, that is unicellular or multicellular. Then mode of nutrition. Plants autotrophic. Plants kaise hai? Autotrophic. And their mode of nutrition is photosynthetic. Autotrophic means which produce their own food. Then fungi. Fungi are saprotrophic. Saprotrophic means which depend on dead or decaying organic matters. Their mode of nutrition is absorption from dead organisms. And third is animals. Animals are heterotrophic and ingestive. Heterotrophic means which depend on another for their food. Like us, we depend on plants and other animals for our food, for our nutrition. Okay. Then fourth is lifestyle. Lifestyle of plants. Plants kaise hai? To producers hai. Animals kya hai? To consumers hai. Aur fungi kya hai? Decomposers. Then phylogenetic relationship. Genetic relationship of prokaryotic to eukaryotic and unicellular to multicellular. Let's see the classification of living organisms. Living organisms are of two types, that are prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Prokaryotes are the unicellular organisms. Kingdom 1 Monera is a unicellular organism without nucleus. Eukaryotes are of two types, that is unicellular and multicellular. Kingdom 2 Protista is an unicellular organism with a well-defined nucleus. Then Kingdom 3 Fungi, Kingdom 4 Plantae and Kingdom 5 Animalia. These are the multicellular living organisms. Now let's see the characteristics of Kingdom Monera. First, all the organisms are unicellular. जितने भी ऑर्गेनिजम्स इन रहते हैं किंगडम मोनेरा में वो सब कैसे है यूनिसेलुलर. दे मे बी ऑटोट्रॉफिक और हेटरोट्रॉफिक. वो कैसे है? एक तो ऑटोट्रॉफिक है और हेटरोट्रॉफिक है. ऑटोट्रॉफिक मीन्स दे प्रिपेयर देयर ओन फूड. हेटरोट्रॉफिक मीन्स दे डिपेंड ऑन अनदर फॉर देयर फूड. देन दीज आर प्रोकैरियोटिक सेल विदाउट डिस्टिंक्ट न्यूक्लियस. मोनेरा कैसे है, तो प्रोकैरियोटिक सेल है जिनके पास न्यूक्लियस नहीं होता। दिस ऑल आर द ऑर्गेनिजम्स फ्रॉम किंगडम मोनेरा। द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ किंगडम प्रोटिस्टा। प्रोटिस्टा आर सिंगल सेल्ड ऑर्गेनिज्म विथ वेल डिफाइंड न्यूक्लियस। प्रोटिस्टा कैसे है, सिंगल सेल्ड ऑर्गेनिजम्स है विथ अ वेल डिफाइंड न्यूक्लियस। दे हैव सुडोपोडिया और हेयर लाइक सीलिया और विप लाइक फ्लैगेला फॉर लोकोमोशन। टू मूव फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर दे यूज दिस सुडोपोडिया और हेयर लाइक सीलिया और विप लाइक फ्लैगेला फॉर लोकोमोशन। दे आर ऑटोट्रॉप्स एंड हेटरोट्रॉप्स। एग्जाम्पल ऑफ ऑटोट्रॉप्स आर Euglena and Volvox, heterotrophs, amoeba and paramoecia. These are the organisms from kingdom Protista. Now, the characteristics of kingdom fungi. First, these are non-green eukaryotic heterotrophic organisms. Fungi कैसे होते हैं? तो non-green eukaryotic, eukaryotic means they have well-defined nucleus and heterotrophic organisms. Heterotrophic means they depend on other for their food. Second, most of them are saprotrophs. That means they depend upon dead or decaying organic matter. Saprotroph means which depend on dead or decaying organic matter for their food. Third, their cell wall is made up of a tough and complex sugar called as chitin. तो फंगी की जो सेल वॉल होती है वो एक टफ और कॉम्प्लेक्स शुगर से बनी रहती है जिसे हम काइटिन कहते हैं। Examples, bacillus, aspergillus, that is fungus on corn, etc. These are the examples of fungi, that is bread mold, aspergillus and penicillium. Then our next topic is classification of microorganisms. What do you mean by microorganisms? The organisms which cannot be seen with the naked eyes is called as microorganisms. Among all the living organisms, microorganisms has the largest number and they are classified as this. Microorganisms are of two types, that is prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Bacteria comes under prokaryotes, protista, fungi and algae comes under eukaryotes. Let's study each of them in detail. Our first microorganism is bacteria. The size of bacteria is 1 micrometer to 10 micrometer. These are unicellular and found in various shapes like spiral, rod or comma. Spiral means like this. Rod means like this. And in comma shape means like this. Okay. Bacterial cells are prokaryotic with cell wall without nucleus. That means bacteria are single cell organisms which is having cell wall but without nucleus. They reproduce by simple binary fission. What do you mean by binary fission? Dividing a single entity into two parts. This bacteria divides itself in two parts. This is known as binary fission. In favorable condition, bacteria grow vigorously and can double their number in 20 minutes. In their favorable condition, they very speedily grow and can double their number in 20 minutes. See how fast they are. These are some type of bacteria. Now let's see our next microorganism, that is protozoa. The next microorganism is protozoa. The size of protozoa is approximately 200 micrometer. They are found in soil, fresh water and sea water. Next, they are unicellular organisms with eukaryotic cells. Means, protozoa kaise hai? Unicellular organisms hai with a well-defined nucleus and cell organelles. They depend on other microorganisms for food or on other protozoans also. Iska matlab kya? Ki ye jo protozoans hai, ye दूसरे माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स के ऊपर डिपेंड रहते हैं फॉर देयर फूड और दूसरे प्रोटोजोन्स के ऊपर भी वो डिपेंड रहते हैं फॉर देयर फूड। एग्जाम्पल अमीबा एंड पैरामोशियम। दीज आर द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ प्रोटोजोन्स, दैट इज पैरामोशियम, अमीबा एंड यूग्लेना। सो आवर नेक्स्ट माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म इज फंगी। फंगी इज द ओनली माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म विच वी कैन सी विद द हेल्प ऑफ ए माइक्रोफाइन ग्लास। size of the fungi is approximately 10 to 100 micrometers. They can found on dead or decaying organic matters. It means they can found on anything which was once alive. It may be dead fruit, dead flowers, dead plants, dead animals, or anything which was once alive. Simply we can say them as dead lovers. These are eukaryotic organisms. That means they have a well-defined nucleus. They are also called as saprotrophs because they feed upon dead and decaying organic matters. Examples of fungi are baker's yeast and mushroom. These are the examples of fungi such as bread mold, aspergillus and penicillium. Our next microorganism is algae. The size of an algae is approximately 10 to 100 micrometer. Algae ki size kya hoti hai? Approximately 10 to 100 micrometer. They are aquatic, eukaryotic, multicellular, autotrophic organisms. Algae kaise hote hai? Toh aquatic hote hai. Eukaryotic means they have well-defined nucleus. They are multicellular, autotrophic organisms. Autotrophic माने वो उनका फूड खुद ही प्रोड्यूस करते हैं. Algae carried the process of photosynthesis with the help of chloroplast. To prepare their own food, they carried the process of photosynthesis with the help of chloroplast. Example, chlorella. So, this is the picture of an algae. Then our last microorganism is viruses. The size of a virus is approximately 10 to 100 nanometers. They are extremely minute, that is 10 to 100 times smaller than bacteria, that can be seen only with electron microscope. Viruses ki size kaisi hoti hai? 10 to 100 times smaller hoti hai. Kisse? Bacteria se. That we can see only with the help of electron microscope. They survive only in living plants and animals and create their numerous replica. वो कहाँ survive करते हैं? Only in living plants and animals. For example, a human body. If the virus enters in a human body, वो क्या करता है फिर? उसके numerous replicas create करता है. Replicas याने duplicates create करता है. Then, they can cause many diseases to plants and animals. Viruses cause many diseases to plants and animals such as influenza virus, chicken pox, and the latest one is coronavirus. This is the animated picture of a virus. So this is all about our first chapter. In the next video, I will teach you the second chapter, that is health and diseases. Till then, take care. Thank you.